Well, time now for a look at what happened in politics today. Green Party leader Elizabeth May was back in front of the cameras discussing the NSICOP report. Last week, May said she was vastly relieved after reading the report, but that is a very different conclusion than the one reached by the NDP leader, who said he was alarmed. The Green leader says she does not believe their conclusions are so far apart, but she wants the dueling press conferences to end. She is inviting all leaders to come together to discuss the NSICOP findings and to formulate an action plan.
Get your top secret security clearance. Let's all have read the report, because dueling press conferences aren't going to help sort this out. If we could sit down together in a secure location where we didn't risk divulging any of the material that we read that's top secret, I think we could come up with an action plan to protect Canada's democracy from foreign interference. The committee has already made a number of recommendations. We need to, I think, work together and set partisanship aside, put Canada first, and give Canadians an assurance that we are acting to push back on foreign interference in Canada.
The Defence Minister Bill Blair answered questions this morning about a Canadian Navy ship anchored in Cuba. Over the weekend, Conservatives condemned the move, questioning why the government would allow a Canadian vessel to dock at the same port as a flotilla of Russian Navy vessels. But Blair says a Canadian ship in the port of Havana was meant to send a message of deterrence.
The deployment of these ships and aircraft sends a very clear message that Canada has a capable and deployable military, and we will not hesitate to do what is required to protect our national interests. Canada will and is committed to maintaining a credible military presence in the sea and in the air around our continent. And any foreign actors coming into our neighborhood can expect to see our armed forces fulfilling their mission to protect Canada's interests. The Canadian Armed Forces will continue to track the movements and activities of the Russian ships. Presence is part of deterrence.
To Israel now, where Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu announced the dissolution of his war cabinet last night. The move comes after the resignation of Benny Gantz and Gadi Eisenkot. Both are moderates and former leaders of the Israeli Defense Forces, and both left the war cabinet, criticizing Netanyahu's handling of the war in Gaza. Mr. Netanyahu says without the war cabinet, decisions about the Gaza offensive will now be made by his pre-existing security cabinet and the larger cabinet attached to his coalition government in the Knesset.